Diet and exercise are the mainstay treatment for most patients and will remain so in the long term. A combination of a hypercaloric diet with a daily reduction of calories of about 500 to 1,000 kilocalories per day and moderate intensity exercise that is achievable by the majority of patients is likely to provide the best likelihood of sustaining weight loss over time. The degree of histological improvement is directly proportional to the amount of weight loss, with at least 7% of weight loss needed for improving histology in patients with NASH. And with weight losses in the range of 9 to 10% or greater being needed for fibrosis improvement. But we all know that losing weight is not easy, and it's also very hard to keep that weight off. What we observe in our daily practice with our patients is that only a very small minority of people can actually sustain the kind of weight loss that is necessary to resolve NASH, unless they undergo bariatric surgery. So there's a real need for pharmacological options to treat NASH. Many drug treatments have been studied for fatty liver disease and for NASH, but none have been approved by the United States Food and Drug Administration or European regulatory agencies for this indication today. However, some drugs have been found to be beneficial for NASH. Of the currently available therapies, the treatments that are supported by the most evidence are vitamin E and pioglitazone, or Actos. However, these therapies are not without concern, as both have been linked to untoward side effects with long-term use. So to recap, why are we so worried about NASH? First and foremost, the sheer numbers are staggering. Given the obesity epidemic we face, as many as 100 million Americans and many, many more around the world who are likely to have fatty liver disease. Given the high prevalence of disease and its estimated rate of progression, significant burden on the healthcare system is anticipated in the near future. In fact, NASH is expected to surpass hepatitis C as the leading reason for liver transplantation in the near future. Furthermore, in addition to the hepatic burden of NAFLD, cardiometabolic risk seen in these patients needs to be addressed. The silent nature of the disease only makes matters worse. Because most patients are asymptomatic, they're unaware that they have NAFLD, and more importantly, that they are at risk for NASH and disease progression. Community awareness of fatty liver disease and NASH for both providers and patients is exceptionally poor, and most patients remain undiagnosed. And finally, beyond weight loss, which we know is an uphill battle for most of our patients, we don't yet have an effective FDA-approved treatment option for NASH.